Learn how to make a trendy business card in today's Illustrator tutorial, perfect for 2018. So let's waste no more time today, guys, but if you do enjoy the tutorial, make sure to share and like my content to support the channel. We need an adequate document for today's business card design, so in Adobe Illustrator, head up to Create a New Document. I'm using millimeters and the standard business card size is 85mm by 55mm. One of the key components that we need to add in this section is the 3mm bleed, and a bleed is crucial for print projects. Also, of course, we need to use CMYK as the color mode, and also high resolution to ensure a crisp printing outcome on your business card design. We will make the front of the business card design first and foremost in today's Illustrator tutorial. So press M for the rectangle tool and then cover the canvas all of the way up to the bleed edge. The bleed edge is represented by the red lines. Lock this down in place as it will resemble the background. You will need to bring your graphics up to the red lines, but all important content such as text and logos will need to be within the black lines. The black line is where the print job is going to be cut, so just keep this in mind for your business card design. Select a gradient in the color palette and then press L for the ellipse tool. Create a circle by holding down Shift on the business card front side. If you then hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag, the circle is going to be duplicated below. And this is a technique that you're going to be very aware of if you watch my channel often. However, you now need to resize the smaller circle by holding down Shift. Select both of the circles and then align them along a vertical plane. And this is very important and you will see why later. Now duplicate the larger circle and then duplicate it one more time above, but make this one larger still. So you now should have two sets of circles like mine here, and select one set of the circles and head up to Object, Blend and Blending Options. We want to use the specified distance setting, and the numerical measurements will depend on the size of your design, but we can change that later. For now, just choose something like 0.3 as I'm doing here. When you've done that, go back up to Object and Blend, but this time select Make. This will create an interesting shape that we're going to utilize later in the tutorial for our business card design. Stay tuned into this step-by-step process in today's tutorial for the final business card design outcome. You can go back into the Blend Settings window and click Preview to see real-time changes if you want to make some adjustments. Repeat the same process for the second set of circles, and then you should end up with something a little bit like this. We're now going to use the Pen tool to make a line that will stretch along the front of your business card design. You'll need to make sure the stroke line is not a color fill, and Shift and X together will toggle between a stroke and a fill. Now we're going to make the really cool function, so select both the line and the blend shape by holding down Shift, and then head up to Object, Blend and Replace Spine. Now I really like this effect, and I think it looks really awesome on a business card, and you can actually use it in many different ways. For now though, lock down this shape by pressing Command or Control 2 on your keyboard. Locate the pen tool again, and start drawing from the end of the line, using a stroke path as we did previously. You can press V to select off of the pen tool path, and this is a quick way to access the selection tool, which I use all of the time. Again, repeat the process of replacing the spine on the stroke path, but with the other blend object. You might experience that the thicker portion of the line starts in the middle, like you can see here. And to rectify this, you simply need to head up to Object, Blend, and then Reverse Spine. Obviously, for your trendy business card design, you can experiment with this function and have some fun with it. By pressing A on your keyboard, you will access a direct selection tool, and then you can adjust the line at the anchor points like you can see here. So we're next going to design the second part of the business card, and then learn how to export perfectly for print in Adobe Illustrator. Just to speed things up in today's Illustrator tutorial, I've gone ahead and added a gradient background by pressing M for the rectangle tool and placing a gradient overlay. I also have an image of myself which I snapped on my DSLR and uploaded to Illustrator. Place the image over the gradient, and then you probably know how much I love to use Illustrator blend modes, so today is no exception. Head into the transparency window and adjust the blend mode. Here you can experiment with different blend modes, and also you might even want to place the gradient over the image and then change the gradient blend mode instead of using the image blend modes. Also, try using multiple different images to get a really neat and kind of like 3D blurry effect, which is actually something that fits into the 2018 graphic design trend. I'm quickly going to show you how to export your design from Illustrator perfectly for print. We're going to want to export a PDF, so go up to File and then use Adobe Printable PDF option. Here, use the most recent version of Acrobat, and then take notes of my settings that I'm using. By default, the compression should be fine, and then in the printing mark settings, you can see the ones I'm using here. If you're printing for a client though, you might want to add in the color bars and also document info settings. Everything else should be fine by default, so go ahead and click the export option. In Adobe Acrobat, you can actually change the view settings to view your business card more efficiently. And here is my final outcome after playing with the blend mode settings on the image of myself. Like I said, have some fun with it and make something really cool with today's business card tutorial. Remember, if you want to boost your awareness and your skills as a graphic designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. I've actually got a lot of suggestions for you guys on future videos, and I'm going to start working through that list very soon. Remember to share my content on social media if you want to help out my channel. And of course guys, until next time, design your future today. Peace.